Can we go on to another topic?
Sure.
Do you, I know you do a lot of research on upcoming or the latest news and stuff. Do you follow global warming very much, that debate?
I follow it only, only marginally. I'm not trained in paleoclimatology, and so I'm very much a layperson, that arena. I mean, my approach is not to be, there's a number of people that are global warming skeptics that have an inherent distrust of the scientific enterprise. And I wouldn't, characterize myself in that way. So I'm not, if a bulk of the scientific community says there's climate change that's happening and we've got data supporting that, I'm inclined to accept that even without necessarily evaluating things for myself.
The only reason why I was asking you is because I saw a recent news article, and I'm also like yourself. I don't really follow it, the debates and things, so I'm not really all that educated about it. But one thing interesting I saw recently in the news, and that's why I wanted to see if you had a take on it, was they were saying because of global warming, it actually threw the Earth cycles off kilter, and so there was supposed to be a coming ice age, and because of the global warming, we're going to miss that ice age. So it's like, oh, does that mean global warming actually was good if we're going to avoid an ice age? I mean, ice age, that's going to be a huge, that's opposite of global warming, and that's going to destroy a lot of things.
Yeah. Yeah, we don't want to go through an ice age. I know that much. Yeah, somebody who I really respect, who you might actually find interesting, maybe even as a guest on your program, is a guy by the name of Kevin Birdwell. He's a Ph.D. in paleoclimatology. He works at Oak Ridge National Labs. And he is an evangelical Christian and has an association with Reasons to Believe kind of on a volunteer basis. And he has one of the most balanced approaches to the question of global warming that I've seen. And kind of his bottom line is there really is climate change that's happening. Human beings probably have precipitated that climate change to some degree, but it's not really clear, how much human activity is actually causing this and how much would have just happened anyway as a result of different, cycles that are in operation in nature. And, his perspective is he's not convinced that some of the attempts that we're taking to remediate global warming are going to be effective. And he argues that we're better off investing in technologies and in activities that would help us to adapt to the changing climate as opposed to trying to stop it from changing. But, you might be interested in maybe at some point having him on the program just to have kind of somebody who actually has studied this quite extensively. That's where his expertise is. And, he does come at it from the perspective of an evangelical, but he seems to me to be very fair-minded and very balanced and thoughtful.
Okay, well, I guess we'll have to end the show on that note. Appreciate you calling in, Fuzz. Really appreciate the conversation. Enjoy it.
Yes, I enjoyed it too, Bernie. Thanks for having me.
Okay, take care.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye.